Hi everyone, welcome to the Basic Science series by Dr. Lokendra Kumar. I have created this program to promote scientific knowledge among students and young researchers. In this episode, we will discuss in detail about blue-white screening method. This method is used to detect the success of gene cloning experiments in molecular biology. Systematically, I will explain about the blue-white screening method and the mechanism associated with this method. Let me explain every component step by step. All right, let's start with cell. Every cell have DNA as their genetic material. DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid and made up of four nitrogenous bases called adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. Adenine and thymine bind together with double bond, whereas guanine and cytosine bind together with triple bond. This bonding makes DNA a strong double-stranded biopolymer. Cells store all the information that is required for their function in DNA in the form of genes. Gene is a small part of DNA that can encode a particular protein. A protein is made up of amino acids, and three-letter DNA code is needed to make a particular amino acid. Finally, the functional protein performs its daily work to ensure the proper working of the cell organelles. This is the chart showing the different codes of DNA making particular amino acid. There are 20 amino acids, and each amino acid has its specific DNA code. For example, TTT and TTC codes for phenylalanine. Here, T means thymine and C means cytosine. It is truly fascinating that nature has chemical coding language for protein synthesis. We will discuss about these mechanisms in our future episodes, and you will be fascinated by how cell works at molecular level and how we have exploited these mechanisms to help human life. Gene can be of variable length depending on the size of the protein. Large protein will have large number of amino acids, therefore will require higher number of codons in DNA sequence. Hence, the size of the gene will be larger in terms of the number of nucleotides. Smaller protein will have smaller number of amino acids, hence will have small number of codons in DNA sequence, and the size of the gene will be smaller. Alright, let's summarize what we have discussed so far. We have discussed about DNA, which is a double-stranded biopolymer that stores genetic information. A gene, which is a part of DNA that encodes a functional protein. And a protein, which is composed of amino acids that perform a particular cellular function so that cell can survive. All right, so we are ready to discuss about the gene cloning technology. In simple words, a gene cloning is the technique when one gene is cut or copied using polymerases or restriction enzymes and pasted in another DNA sequence using ligases enzymes. In simple terms, taking a small segment of DNA from one DNA strand and pasting in another DNA strand is called gene cloning. After performing the copy function of the gene, the same gene is pasted into the plasmids. The plasmids are the extracellular DNA molecules that can be used to transfer genetic information from one cell to another. Imagine a genetic material as computer CPU and plasmid as a pen drive, where you can copy the gene and take the pen drive to another CPU. Now, another CPU has the same information as the first CPU. Plasmids are circular DNA strands and made up of repeating ATGC nucleotide sequences. They are also DNA strands and are circular in structure. Plasmids are engineered DNA strand, and each sequence in the plasmid have its own function. Let's know about basic structure of the plasmids. In plasmid, one sequence is origin of replication sequence. Using this sequence, plasmid starts dividing in the cell independent of the cell division. So a cell can have a high number of plasmids. Another sequence is marker sequence. It is an antibiotic resistance gene present in the plasmid so that a cell can survive under antibiotic pressure. Third is multiple cloning site. This is the site where you can paste the gene of interest that is copied from another cell's DNA. How the copy-paste function of the gene is performed is very interesting. First, a plasmid is digested with restriction endonuclease enzymes that cuts the plasmid at specific sites, leading to the formation of ends that binds perfectly with the gene sequence. Since the gene sequence is complementary to the sequence of the plasmid, therefore it binds perfectly. When gene is pasted in the plasmid, this complete process is called gene cloning. Now, to detect the success of gene cloning experiments, molecular biologist has developed a very interesting method of blue-white screening. This method works on the basis of color of bacterial colonies. The color will tell you which colony have the gene of interest and which do not have the gene of interest. When this copy and paste function of gene is getting performed, there is a good chance that some plasmid will survive without having gene in it. These plasmids are called empty plasmids or the control plasmids. So to find out which bacteria have the plasmid with gene and which bacteria have just the plasmid without any gene, the blue-white screening method was invented. I hope that you remember about the plasmid that we have discussed previously in this presentation. As I mentioned before in this presentation about multiple cloning sites where the gene is pasted, the multiple cloning sites in the plasmid is present inside a specific gene. The name of the gene is LacZ gene, which produces an enzyme named beta-galactosidase. Most importantly, this only produces a small part of that particular gene. Therefore, it does not produce the full functional protein. This part is known as the alpha polypeptide. This alone cannot function as the active full-length enzyme. There are special E. coli bacterial strains that are used during cloning experiments. One of the strains is DH5-alpha. They have genetic modification, but the most important modification in their DNA is that they have the other portion of beta-galactosidase gene, which is omega polypeptide. When a plasmid is present in the bacterial cell, the alpha polypeptide gene produces alpha unit and the bacteria produces the omega unit, leading to the formation of fully functional beta-galactosidase gene. This gene degrades a colorless chemical compound known as X-gal to produce a blue-colored chemical compound known as 5,5-dibromo-4,4-dichloroindigo. Therefore, the bacterial cells with the plasmid appear blue on the media containing X-gal. Plasmid also have another marker, that is antibiotic resistance gene, to kill the bacterial cells that are devoid of plasmids. So if you add antibiotic, which is in most of the cases is ampicillin, the cells without plasmid will not grow since they do not have the ampicillin resistance gene. A very important question is that what happens if you paste a gene into the plasmid's multiple cloning site? What will happen is it is going to disrupt the sequence of alpha polypeptide unit of the gene. Since a new sequence is inserted in the middle of the gene, therefore alpha polypeptide will no longer be synthesized. Now, bacteria will produce the omega unit, but without the alpha unit, it cannot synthesize full beta galactosidase gene. Therefore, the bacteria will not produce an active enzyme and X-gal will not be converted into a blue-colored product. Hence, the cell will appear white instead of blue. Therefore, after cloning experiments, you will get blue and white colonies. White colonies in your media plates are the colonies that you should select and screen for your protein. This method is a very simple way to select the plasmids with the gene of interest in it. In summary, a gene of interest is copied from a host cell DNA and it is pasted into the plasmid. Now, the success of inserting the DNA in the plasmid is performed using blue-white screening. This is one of the exciting tools of genetic engineering. We will cover a lot of exciting methods and tools and technique of genetic engineering in future. If you haven't subscribed the channel, please subscribe the YouTube channel to get updates on new presentation on basic science topics. This presentation will help you in your studies and will also prepare you for competitive exams. With this note, I conclude the presentation. Please like and share the presentation with students and young researchers. Please forgive my mistakes.